Hi guys, welcome to DJava tutorial. Today's topic is Java Object Oriented Programming System Class 2. In this class, we will explain about encapsulation in Java. What is encapsulation? Definition of encapsulation is like binding, the process of binding up of data and code together into a single entity. That is called as encapsulation. So by meaning, what is the meaning of that? In Java, data means variables in a particular class, and code means the methods which are written over that variables to do the different behaviors. So the binding of the both the data as well as the code is called as encapsulation. Now we'll explain it with an example in the next section. Now what is the before going for the further we need to explain how we can achieve encapsulation in Java. In Java, we achieve encapsulation through creating private variables and creating the getters and setter methods for the particular variables. And doing that, we will achieve the perfect encapsulation in Java. Now let us see the example for this, whatever I said. Now we'll see an example program for encapsulation. So I had already taken the same bird object which I explained the class in the last lecture, and this bird will have two properties, which is I have made the both the properties name and color as private members. So private members means the visibility of this particular members is within this class and it cannot be accessed from outside the class. So that is why I create those two variables private. After making them private, I had provided two methods, get name and set name for name. So these two methods are called as getters and setters. Getter will get the particular variable's value and setter will set the values to the method. Why we use getters and setters is to provide an abstraction for the particular variable so that the variable will not be modified from directly from the other way, other places. Only through getters and setters we should be able to modify the variables. Now let us see the how we can create getters and setters. Getters and setters can be created by right click and going for source in Eclipse. We can do like that in Eclipse. I have created these getters and setters like that. Now after creating getters and setters, we need to see the code for setter is like I have used this keyword. This keyword means the parameter what I am passing and the variable within the class is having the same name. So I have to mention this keyword too so that the class identifies that the variable which I am referring is of this instance of the class, and it will give the value of the object into the whatever I am passing to the parameter, that value will be inserted to the object in the class. So that is the getter and setter. So I created the getters and setters. After that, like last class I had created an object of crow, and I am initializing this crow object with two values. For crow I am given a black color and name as crow, and after that I am printing these values by using getter method. Setter method I am using to set the particular variable values, and I am using getter method to get the values. That is the output of the program. Let us see the output. The name will be crow and the color is black. That is the output of the program. So this is the encapsulation in Java using Java methods and how we have done this video. In this video, please subscribe to my channel and like the videos for more videos on object-oriented programming. Thank you for watching this video.